Hello, welcome to my stream. Today I'll be playing more of Xenogears, and yesterday we were able to finally open the last gate to Solaris. So today I'm expecting to go there. Today I'm expecting to finally get to Solaris. So hopefully we can prepare ourselves to that trip, and then we can go there, see what's going on in there. I'm expecting a lot of plot to happen, because Solaris is one of the most important places in this game, it seems. But hopefully we'll be alright. Yesterday we were playing with a very odd party, which is Faye, Chuchu and Billy right there. And so it surprised me, because that party kind of worked. Like, I was able to really enjoy having Chuchu and Billy in my party. Billy, of course, I liked him, because he's probably my favorite character in the game so far. But Chuchu was helpful, especially because of her healing abilities, and because I can restore her EPs with items during gear fights. So that was pretty useful, that was pretty helpful. Of course, some battles took long, especially because I was in need to restore my fuel for Faye and for Billy. But yeah, things were good. I feel like I learned a little bit more about strategies thanks to yesterday's stream, especially after having a game over. Because after I died, I realized that I could maybe have some good items to give to my characters, and I had them. I had some electricity protection that I was kinda ignoring for the entire game. So now I will kind of try to work more with my accessories and items, because the game is also getting harder. So yeah, I feel great, because I was able to pay more attention to that yesterday, and I'm pretty sure that will be super important for whatever is happening next. So early Vadin, how are you guys doing? Welcome. Vadin, thankfully the World Cup is over, right? So you might be able to get some peace again in your country. Hopefully things will like stay normal or go back to normal, and then you don't have the loud noises anymore or anything that was bothering you. And early, glad to hear that you're having a great Sunday, and I hope you can go play another RPG game, hopefully a blind one that you have never played before. Isis's? I have never heard of that one. You played it years ago? Think old school text-based PC RPGs. I don't know if I have ever played one, because usually when I think about text-based games, they have some other things going on too. They are not like pure text-based, you know? When I think on text-based RPGs, I think on RPGs maybe like, I don't know, Persona and Earthbound, but I'm pretty sure they are not like that, because they have other elements as well. I'm just saying those because the text is strong in those two games, or the dialogue is strong in those two games, but they are not like pure text. They have animations, they have cutscenes, they have effects, visual effects and things. So I don't know if I can think on a text-based RPG, because maybe that's too old for me to think on one. Or maybe I have never played one. Yeah, it's just pure-based text, right? I don't think I have ever had too much experience with those games. Especially because real-life RPG is something that I have never played too. And I'm guessing that those text-based RPGs, they demand a lot of your imagination, because you don't have the graphics, you don't have the effects and everything. As so the in real life RPG, because you also need to think on everything, to picture everything. So I'm kind of a newbie to those things. But I don't know, man, I hope then you can go back to Isis's and then you have fun with it. I don't know how old it is, but yeah, I hope it's not like how can I say it? I hope it hasn't aged too much, because there are some old games that the fact that they have aged can be bad for today, you know? Maybe grinding can be a problem or something like that. Yeah, maybe someday, maybe someday. I do still have other games to play before trying something like that. Especially the one that we were discussing in the past, Myst. I still need to play that puzzle game because it seems to be a very classic one and I have never played it. So yeah, we first should play that one and then later try to find something else, something different like a text RPG. And also you recommended me to play, I believe, a Genesis RPG too. So I also need to play that game. I never remember the name of it, but it's Shining something, right? Shining in the dark, maybe? Shining in the darkness? It's something like that. Shining in the darkness, okay, so never mind, I do remember the name of the game. Only downside is there is no you beat the game, so you kind of make your own goals. Another reason why you need to be very creative or very imaginative, you need to have a great imagination or things to help your experience through the simple game, you know, because it's a simple game. But yeah, let me start Xenogears. Let's see if I can first find a shop, because I do want to check my armors, my weapons, my stuff. And then I will try to go to Solaris. Early, is there a more famous game that is just like a text-based RPG? Maybe I could also say, for example, the Phoenix Wright games, but it's different because it's not like... I don't know if I could call it an RPG because it doesn't have some RPG element. It's more like an investigation slash puzzle game. But it's totally text-based. It has some exploration too, like point and click. But the main part of the plot is... Or the main part of the game is totally text-based because you need to interpret the things you read, you need to connect the information. But I'm pretty sure when you are doing that with an RPG, it's different. Yeah, I would need to look up for some old PC RPG games, right? Yeah, I don't think I have ever played one. But I was hoping that you had a name for a very famous one that maybe I could have heard of. So I don't think there is a shop in here, so I'm going to leave and I'm going back to the old city. Because I know at least there is a shop in there. Maybe it will be like outdated. And if it is outdated, then I will go back to Nissan. Because the shop in Nissan... Not the Nissan one, right? I could go back to Thames. Yeah, maybe Thames has a better shop now. You know what? Let's go back to Thames. I'm not even sure if it is still worth it to check the shop in the old city here. Gabriel, welcome. How are you doing, man? Back to find angels? Man, this freaking angel, right? I know this angel for a long time, but I never understood why it was there. So, thankfully, the puzzle was over yesterday. But how are you doing tonight? I just started the stream and I'm finding a shop. Because I don't want to go to Solaris. Unprepared, right? I don't want to go there without gear, upgrades and armors and things. Also, I was talking to It's Too Early right there about some old RPGs that are like old text RPGs or text-based RPGs. I wonder if you have ever played one. Because I don't think I have. I even don't know the name of a single game that is like text-based RPG. But you have played some RPGs in your life, so I wonder if you have heard of one, or if you know one, if you have ever played one. Yeah, it seems to be that Early wants to play a super old text-based RPG. And I was trying to think on a game, but I can't because I really haven't played one. My best approach were like games that have a lot of dialogue and text, but they have graphics, they have like animations, cutscenes, effects. So they can't be text-based RPGs, you know, like the old school games. Oh, you have played in the past? Yeah, that's something that I have never done. I wonder if you have ever played the in real life RPG as well, because if you're playing a text-based RPG or if you're playing the in real life RPG, you need to have a great imagination so you can picture everything. So I don't think I have that experience because I also have never had a section with a real life RPG. So the shopping here, I think it was down there. It is pretty easy. So you have played it. Know, because I think that if I need to play in real life RPG someday, I don't think I can be the person telling the story, you know, because I don't know if I can create a plot or a story like that. Remito, hi, how are you doing? Mega Man X, it's happening, man. It's happening. How are you tonight? Oh, you use it to be a dungeon master? You see, I can't see myself being a person like that. Remito, you're also a huge fan of RPG games. So I wonder if you have ever played a text-based RPG. Because I have never, and we are discussing that. Wait, so that maybe it wasn't here. Yeah, I think this is the place. Multiple ones? Can you give me some names to see if I can recognize? Because I have never played one, but maybe I have heard of something. Everyone here tried their hand at being the game dungeon master. They preferred Taube players. What? Oh, they preferred 2B players. Okay, 2B players. Yeah, I think if I have that experience in my life, I would prefer to be a player as well. I don't think I would be able to create an universe and things like that. You have created a pseudo campaign for one? It's not as hard. Yeah, I have the impression that it is super hard. But I don't know, maybe it is simple. Maybe both, like the text RPG and the in real life RPG, maybe they are simpler than I think. But yes, the impression I have is that it's something like you need to have a lot of creativity, you need to be inspired. But maybe in the end it's just like people how can I say it? People following the flow of things, you know? And then things will just flow naturally, instead of you worrying too much about having a solid idea of what's going to happen. No, maybe it just happens and then you create something out at the moment. It's happening. I don't know. Kingdom of Loathing, that's one that I have never heard before. Yeah, MUDs, that's the same term Early was using. So there are different types of text-based RPGs. Because MUD seems to be like multiplayer, right? Or multi-user or something. Yeah, I can only think on visual novels. Maybe that's a better way to put it. For example, like Phoenix Wright, which is kind of visual novel too, but not really. I also was thinking a little bit on Persona, but Persona has the turn-based battles. So I was just thinking on the simulation part of Persona. Yeah, it isn't an RPG. Yeah, that there is also that. Phoenix Wright is more like investigation / puzzle game, but it is a little bit like a visual novel, don't you think? Because of how dialogue is important and everything. They are also turn-based, yeah. Maybe they just don't have the visuals. But it's hard to imagine, though. I was also thinking on Earthbound because the text in there is super strong. Like, everything you do will be, like, super very well described in the text. So I was also thinking a little bit on Earthbound. It gives me the idea or the impression of a text-based RPG, but of course it's not. So let me check the parts in here. I don't have a lot of money, actually. I was expecting to have much more money. And by the way, again, I'm seeing Esmeralda in my party. It's crazy that I still don't have her, like, officially confirmed in my party. But I can see her icon in there. Besides, you leave your gears in Shevet. Yeah, this seems to be a very plain shop, right? With some items that I already have. You have started Final Fantasy VIII yesterday. What did you think about it? Let me check Tuna. Yeah, that's Esmeralda's gear. Oh my god, she's so strong. Yeah, she has an item that's like the double of these items. I guess I'll try going back to Thames. And then if I don't think the items in there are worth it, I will just head to Solaris and hope there is a shop in there. Yeah, you are right in there. Most RPGs are heavily text-based because of the plot development and everything. Unless they have like cutscenes every time to tell this story. If you have never played a tabletop RPG, yes, I don't think... Wait, a tabletop? By tabletop, do you mean like in real life RPGs, right? Yeah, I think you are talking about real life RPGs. I have never played that. Toby, hi, how are you doing? Thank you so much for the auto host. Do me a favor, skip the tutorial? Really? I probably won't when I'm playing, or when I decide to play Final Fantasy VIII. Because I'm pretty sure there will be something that I might learn about the game, or about something, right? About the battles or the mechanics. There is always something that I never realize about those games. It took you, wait, 2 hours and 30 minutes to read through the entire tutorial? And I'm not a slow reader? Really? Is it that bad? Yeah, can't you skip things? Or at least parts of it? How can I leave this place? I would need to go to the palace, I think. Actually, no, it's the dock. And then I can find the ship, right? But I usually don't skip tutorials. Because, like I said, I think they might teach me something that I might not know. Six tutorials? Up to 30 topics? Oh my. I probably wouldn't read everything, but I would read some things, like things that I suspect that I might not know too much. Half of them were misspelled, typos, or just re-references to themselves. Yeah, if they are being repetitive in there, that sucks. Tiny bits of information in there, it's basically hidden. Yeah, I would read just what I feel like reading. But the tutorial won't like make you hate the game, you know? It's okay, like just skip it and enjoy the experience. Hopefully you can get to better parts in the game next. So you can like move on from this idea of a bad tutorial. So let me see. I want to go to Thames. Thames is to south. One of the topics was information menus. That's so strange. Yeah, when he said like skip the tutorial, I would skip the tutorial, but probably I wouldn't skip everything. I would see what I feel like familiarized with and what I'm not oh my god, that's a hard word. And the things I'm not familiarized with to read. Thames, where are you, please? I kind of forgot where it was. Wait, it's definitely not in there. Why is it being so hard to find it? That's the Tower of Babel, or the Babel Tower. That's the Ita's place. Maybe they have moved. That's the orphanage. I give up. I can't find the freaking Thames. Junction over 175 times? Wait, there is something moving. It's them. They are moving. That's why I couldn't find them. Why are they moving? Thank you. Really, Remito? No, man. People shouldn't hate a game just because of the tutorial. And I'm pretty sure you could have skipped it, right? Let's go to the deck. Playing 5 before 8. I probably won't, man. I'm kinda settled on playing 8 next. I sometimes do spend some time reading those tutorials and things, because I'm curious, and also I usually learn something new that I might have forgotten or never heard of before. But if it is that bad, I can skip some things. Where would be the shop? The shop, I believe, was like supply entrance. Was it in there? I think it was in here. So, are you selling old things? That's not old, actually. The game actually doesn't seem all that bad. Yeah, there might be some strange or weird mechanics, at least from what I heard. For example, the job thing. But I'm pretty sure there are some other good things too. Yes, Vadin, don't spoil, man. Probably you want to tell me something like, oh, but in Solaris you can buy new things or better things. But that's okay, man. Don't worry. And this shows it to me that I was up to date, like, to the things yesterday. And the enemies were very tough. But this was like the last shop I had access, and the enemies were very strong. I couldn't read the name of the person that followed me, but thank you so much for the follow. Maybe I should check it. Let me pause the game a little bit. Give me a second, guys. That sucks because I have the alerts off in here. So sometimes if I'm not fast enough, I don't get the name of the person that's following me. But it's okay, I'm opening the alerts now. Blake, thank you so much for the follow. There we go. So now I can go back to everything. It was Blake, yes. I just checked it in here. Yeah, Final Fantasy II is the game that most people tell me to not try. Because it seems that it hasn't aged very well and it was, I don't know, bad, for different reasons. I wonder if there is something good about Final Fantasy II actually. I wonder if at least music was good in that game. Yeah, I think Solaris might have better things, but I don't know how the game will be progressing, right? Riker, welcome. How are you doing? I couldn't find a shop in Shevet, so I returned here. And I bought some few things, not too much things because I was poor. But now I'll try to go to Solaris. It is the black ship? I was thinking that Final Fantasy VI was the black ship. Not in a bad way, though. But there is, or should I ask, is there something good about Final Fantasy II? Like music or something? Or maybe the characters? Yeah, Final Fantasy I, I know that it has aged a lot, so grinding can be painful and everything, but people tell me that's worth it, especially because of the plot of it. Wait. Yeah, I mean, like, black sheep doesn't need to be a bad thing. It just means like something different, right? Usually people interpretate different things as bad things, but I'm going in a better interpretation, like it's just different. And I'm referring to Final Fantasy VI because I don't know how Final Fantasy II is like. And you know what? I'm going to save the game in here. Also, since I'm here, let's go check why Esmeralda is in my party or something. You can't think of anything good about two. Can you say something, Riker? Because you said that it's not that bad. Why do you think Final Fantasy II is not that bad? Wait, really? Final Fantasy I didn't have a story or a bit of story? That goes against what I have heard of it. And two had story. But like Persona 1, didn't age well. Yeah, Persona 1 definitely didn't age very well. Yeah, one had story too, yeah. But maybe it is not as good as I was thinking or as strong as I was thinking. She's really there, but why I have the impression the game hasn't confirmed that she was about to be a party member? Maybe it's because I didn't see a message like Esmeralda joined our party that I usually see in other games. Anyways, let me check what she can do. Equip Power Crisis. Wait, that's Faye. That's Faye. There we go. Devil Dress, Ether Stone, Large, and a Speed Ring. And she has a lot of defense, but she's super slow. Actually, never mind. She's faster than Billy and Faye. Why agility is such a low stat? The Mermaid Mail is very good. I mean, it's not better than the Devil Dress, but it's close. I will change the speed ring. Yeah, I'll give her that, the long dark coat. A nanobolt wind attack, a nanocube earth attack, a waterfall water attack, and then a fire attack, and they are all for single enemies. And then we have the multi-target one, a firestorm. Yeah, she's just like Ellie but made better. Oh, you can wait. You guys are talking too much right now. Final Fantasy 2 is fine. It's still a Final Fantasy game. With a lot of sequels, they tried some wacky new things that are just a little weird. But it has strong characters, story, music. I see, it's better than one regarding those things. And you could really cheese the battle system. Sharknado is fun, but it's still bad. I guess we'll use Esmeralda a little bit, but if she's better than Ellie, what happens to Ellie? Like, is she like an Ellie clone or something? Let's go to Solaris. Wish me luck. First, I need to find Shevet again. I don't remember what it was, but I think it was the south. No, because that's Babel's Tower, then we have the orphanage. Maybe it's not in there, maybe it is in another direction. She is not a human. Yeah, she's a robot. But she says that she's like the daughter of Faye. That's weird. What was this again? Is this Kislev? I think that's Kislev. Oh, I think I remember where it was. Wait a second, it was actually down there, to south. Yeah, this is a great song for sure. No, never mind. I was thinking it could have been there, but nope. Oh, remember this? Still don't know what that's about. Oh, Shevet. Shevet was by the... Wait a second. Shevet was at top of Babel's Tower at first, but... I don't know if I can return there by coming back here. Because that was a better place to get to Shevet. Like, there was a place in the overworld. I'll keep looking for it. It is moving. Okay, so I will try to pay more attention. Because yes, there was another way to get there. Wait, but I... That's probably the Thames, yeah, that's the Thames, but... I can't see something else moving on the map. So I will need to find it. Wait, did that move? Okay, there we go. It moves, but it's slower. We are back. This is like Etrian Odyssey music. I have never played it, but I think that... maybe I'm wrong, but I have the feeling that the same composer of Persona games is the same one for Etrian Odyssey, am I right? I'm talking about Shoji Meguro. Maybe he wasn't behind the Etrian Odyssey music. But for some reason I was thinking he was. If he is the one behind the soundtrack for Etrian Odyssey, then I'm pretty sure it's a great soundtrack, because I do love his music. Yeah, I know it's an Atlus game, but I didn't know if he was the composer or something. Yeah, I agree with you. Shoji Meguro is amazing, amazing composer. Probably my favorite composer of the most recent years or recent games or something. At the moment, right? Maybe I should say that he's my favorite composer at the moment or at the present. Okay, so let's go back to the palace. Shevet, the 11th month in Hebrew calendar. It is usually a period mid-January, February. I had no idea about that. I actually didn't know there was a Hebrew calendar. Yeah, let's go. We are dependent on you, Maria. Please transport us to Solaris on the Zipzen. Yes, Zipzen is ready to go anytime. Oh, this game is filled with Hebrew stuff and Kabbalah. Maybe I could see Kabbalah stuff, but I didn't know about Hebrew stuff. Zipsen, let's go! Definitely one of the coolest things about this game are the cutscenes. I'm coming, Solaris. Zipzen and I shall be the dark wings which carry you all to your deaths. It has a lot of cutscenes. I hope they are good ones. I'm not saying that cutscene games are always fun, but if they have good cutscenes, then it's a plus. This is the barrier. Please, Zipzen. Menuing is horrific. A gravitational, I guess? A gravitational field is opening. The space distortion correction is starting. Rip my computer. But she did it. Oh my god, Remito, the cutscenes are better than the actual game. It can't be that bad. Wait. Gravity? Like, we are upside down now? It's dangerous to move in a big group. We'll take separate routes. Wait, routes. That's another word that I need to practice how to pronounce it correctly. It's routes. I always say it like roots, but roots is like the thing the plants have. The plants and the trees have. It's routes. Don't worry, I'm good at gathering info. Oh my god, what you're doing here, Hammer? I still don't trust him. Seriously? I could say it like roots? Okay, is it something that happens like in the US, or is it something that happens because of, for example, American accent and then English accent? It is like tomato, you could say it like tomato or tomato. Maybe it is because in other countries it kinda... It's like 50-50. Man, English is so weird. How can a freaking word be pronounced in many ways? Like, it's so confusing. Oh wait, to root an enemy's attack? Or to plan a route ahead? I'm not sure if I could see the differences, like, about the meaning in there. I mean, you are telling me that there is, like, the verb and now, because to root an enemy's attack is the verb, and then to plan a route ahead is like the noun. Final Fantasy 8 and 9 had 4 discs, and it's mostly due to cutscenes and music? Wait, both are verbs? Wait, but to plan a route, so that's a noun. Yeah, it's a verb and a noun. And sometimes, actually maybe not sometimes, but... I know that when you have a word that can have like... different meanings, depending if it is a noun or a verb, for example, the word like record, then it will be like a noun or a verb depending on the accent. For example, if you say like record, it's a noun, and if you say record, it's like the verb. But for that word right there, for root, the accent is weird, you know? Remitor normally goes with route when talking about war things, like routing an enemy's attack, which sounds like the verb, or route when it's like the noun. Yeah, sometimes the same word can have like different accents or pronunciations. But I was confused about that word. But maybe in the end it doesn't matter too much, like you can say it like you want. Oh, to rout someone means to make them retreat? That's something new, I didn't know about that. I was thinking it was like to... I don't know, to spy or to plan or to... identify the enemy's strategies or something, but I didn't know it was like to make them retreat, you know? So basically you are saying to your enemies like, you can't win, so stop fighting and then walk away through that route, you know? So they will be retreating. That makes sense. Which is different than route, which is away. Yeah, I was thinking the meaning was always like to find a way or to have a way. But no, I didn't know it was also to make people to retreat. So to rout someone is different than to rout away or to root or both. Rout to anyone in Pokemon. You just like to watch others' misery. You will just get in the way. Forgive me, sorry. Maria? Yes, what is it? The disorder Zipsen caused when breaking the gate has almost cleared up. You and everyone else must leave before the enemy detection system activates again. We will take care of the rest. Okay, be careful. Okay, so there goes one party, like Faye, Saiton, and Ellie. But when will I like pick my own party to keep progressing? Because they did it automatically. This party was built totally by the game, not by my actions. It seems like the world's upside down, it's creepy. Solaris gravity is the opposite that of the land. We don't have time to explain, we will get used to it. Will we? Like, actually maybe we will, because I was thinking on like being upside down in real life and then the blood would flow to your brain. But if gravity is inverted, then your blood will still flow to your like feet, you know? So maybe they will be alright. It is uncomfortable for us on the surface at first. Hey, what's this? It looks like some kind of storage or distribution center. I'm not sure, but it's probably used to ship off extra supplies, materials, and fuel gathered from the surface. These are the technology products you land dwellers receive from the Itas. For now, shall we gather some information? So I will be playing as them, even if I didn't have the option to pick this party. Let me check their accessories, because I probably can change phase accessory. Oh, I actually have changed that before. Yes, I swapped the electric defense accessory to this one. Then that's Titan, a metal jacket, a metal helmet. Oh, I probably can change that. If they turned off the gravity, yeah, then we are dead. By the way, sometimes my controller analog stick gets crazy, so that happens sometimes. I think it's getting stuck at some moments. It's also doing some more noises when I move it. You know what? Maybe I won't change that. I was expecting to have something better, but having some ether defense is good. Wait a second. that. That's better. And that's the best one. Then Ellie has the dynamite rod. I'll give her the dark rod. Then the mermaid mail. And the war helm, right? And then she has some evasion. I'll give her the anti-eater stone. I'm not sure if that will be useful, so we'll need to see how the enemies in this place behave. If they don't use beam attacks, we can change that. Oh my god! This is actually very, very good. That's even better. Look at that! Yeah, someone needs to have this. How is Faye doing? Yes, I can change that now. Faye will get the Eater armor plus one. Pretty sure I have an extra armor plus five. There we go. Then we don't need old circuits anymore. I'm giving people more Eater defense, so hopefully that's a good choice. Wait a second, but he needs to have... Yeah, he needs to have like a recovery option. And I took it from him. Are you telling me that I don't have it? Is this one the only one I can use? I don't know where to find more of the frame HP 50, but I will buy more as soon as I find it. So I need to have that in my mind. And let's go. Let's see what's ahead of waiting for us. And by the way, this will be painful. Oh my god. I hope you guys don't have like motion sickness. Is this a container from the transport system Ellie was talking about? Well, I'm not sure, but I think I have seen this before. Shall we take a look? What are you saying? We don't have time for that. We have to get out of here quickly. Didn't you say we had to gather information? We could probably sneak in using this thing. Rip! There goes Faye. Good luck, mate. I see you. Hopefully, in another time. Wait, what the hell is that? That's a save point. Oh, it's first person view. Oh my. Okay, thankfully they are fixing the camera once we get inside, it seems. Well, where am I now? I guess you are inside of Solaris. Files, save. Can we get to the others? This place looks like a beehive. No, I can't handle it anymore. Something is wrong with all of you, working like machines day after day. You have no will. This isn't living. This is slavery. Stop it. Let go. So, what they have in here is like the opposite. It's like the opposite of what it should be happening. Like, the machines should be working in place of humans, but in here the machines are making the humans work. I mean, the humans that are still alive, because we just lost a guy. What the hell was that? A lot of people have tried to change their IDs and escape lately. They usually get caught and rearranged or re-educated. Don't you even think of trying to escape? I want to move up a rank to second class citizen. Then I can finally live with the second class. You have got no business at the watchtower, beat it. How can you not be happy with all of this? Do as you are told and get promoted. What is there to be discontented about? I didn't know that was a word in English, because it sounds a lot like Portuguese. Discontented. This is the dust chute. The third class citizens have nothing to do with this. Go back where you came from. Oh my, I'm already lost. Because this place has such a weird camera too. Have I spoken to you? Yes, I have. What a fool! If he hadn't bucked the system, he could have lived peacefully. K-Block? They are all being rearranged. Poor guys, and they worked so hard too. Even if you think so, that doesn't mean the administration does. What's wrong with this person? It's the best to follow the administration. It could affect your rank, you know? Is that a door? It's not. Return to 10-4-1. Yes? Oh! Faye? Ellie! You are so careless! If you're trying to infiltrate the base, you have to be subtle. I'm sorry, well, where are we? We are in the Solaris 3rd class F block. F block. There's around 20 blocks, each with land dwellers living in them. We Solarians are private? Are private to all personal info. Everyone's DNA structure is inscribed on a molecular level. And even their class, you know what these citizens are called? No? Okay, so the beehive thing was a thing. Worker bees. It came from the shape of their housing blocks. These people provide the manual labor. It's labor, right? The manual labor vital to the support of Solaris Core. I took a field trip here once long ago. I remember thinking that their lives had nothing to do with me. I never thought I would end up here like this. Which means you should know your way around here, Ellie. Vaguely, we need to escape first. Where is Saiten? Indeed, where is Saiten? He took a different pod looking for you. He may have ended up in a different block. Damn, we are all spread out. I wouldn't worry about Saitam, he knows the city better than I do? How? I wonder if Bart and them made it okay. Let me see if I can remember this right. Saitam and Billy's father, Jesse. And also, I believe, Sigurd. They all had things to do about Solaris in the past. I think they were either researchers or experiments or something here. But they were able to escape. But I'm not sure if I'm remembering this right. And then we have Ellie. Ellie had the mental breakdown because they were doing experiments on her. And then somehow she also was freed from Solaris. And then she joined Gabler. But she was like working for Gabler. They were in Solaris military. Yeah, I kind of remember that Cyton and Sigurd had something to do with this place, but I wasn't sure what that was. Was also Jesse part of the military? Because I also remember Jesse being part of something here. And Ellie was more like a test subject, right? Ellie was like under experiments that they were doing on her. Okay, Jesse's with them, so they should be fine. I hope so. Anyway, let's move on. Okay, at least I'm not alone anymore. Let's go check the other pods. This is giving some Crash Bandicoot feels to me, because Crash Bandicoot also has some pods like this. They were all the previous generation of the Elements group in Gambler. So, Cyton, Sigurd, Jesse, and I guess the Bishop guy. I don't think I will be able to remember his name anymore, but the Bishop that we have met when we were doing Ramses. So the Bishop was not part of that. But that Bishop knew Cyton very well, or at least I think he knew Cyton. Maybe not. I can't remember it right anymore. Don't rebel rouse here. Just work, eat, and sleep. Just keep doing that and you leave. If anyone complains, your or our. If anyone complains, our entire unit will be punished too. Which means we all get rearranged. You never come back. The Bishop studied in Jugend with them. Jugend. Where was Jugend? Was it in the land? Or is it like a city in Solaris or something? The only place I know about Solaris is called Itrenenk, because it seems to be Solaris' capital, and I have it in my paper right here. Jugend is the officer school for Gabler in Solaris. Okay, so it wasn't here. Timothy? Unfortunately, I'm not Timothy. The name is Samson. But hey, I know you. Who is Timothy? How do you know me? Who are you? From the tournament. Unfortunately, I lost the first round. I passed out on the way home. And when I came to, I found myself here. Everyone else got what they call rearranged. It's a cross between brainwashing and amnesia. But they messed up on me and I can't still remember. Then what about that last person? Yeah, him too. He died in vain. One of my few friends too. He was his best friend, Mayhan? Is he the guy that was going to marry someone else? Because I remember that there was a marriage, right? But then the plans got cancelled because of the crisis in there. And I believe that we... Did we kill the bride? That's something that I don't remember exactly anymore, but someone died, I think. And I think it was the bride. I'm not going out like that. You know that guard tower near us? I'm going through it past the second class block. Sneak into the naval port and kiss Solaris goodbye. So he's planning to escape. Can you do that? Yeah, cause I got a pass. They got me working at the naval port. I'm only supposed to leave when it's my shift, but I solved that little snag. Hey, why don't you come along? With your power, we would be set. Choices? Is this like a bad ending? I will say no, because I need to keep exploring this place. But maybe he's the way to progress. I won't force you, it is pretty risky, but if you change your mind, come talk to me. We would be set? I think I lost something in there, Rimito. Yeah, he kinda wants me to return here and talk to him again, so maybe this is the way to progress, but first I want to see if I'm not losing or missing anything else in here. But everyone was blocked, like all the doors are blocked. Yeah, they don't allow me to get to some places. So the couple was killed, like Timothy and also the bride, which was the sister of another character. So basically what I have seen right now is like Solaris using dead bodies and giving them life again? Because of him, I'm probably going to get rearranged. God, if you are there, please save me. This guy just resembles him. Oh, that's why Faye was like surprised at first, but then he kind of changed the topic later. With the set? Oh, it's because I'm saying the entire thing, right? Only one winged angel exists. It's now OS Frog, I hate it. I hate that they have changed it back. Can I? No, I can't go to the right. Okay. that's Komodo hype. I miss when all the animals were like OS animal. Oh, there is a save point in here. Let's use it. And then it seems like we can only progress if we say yes to Timothy or to Samson. So far, this place is not as big as I was imagining, which is a good thing, because then we don't lose a lot of time exploring. Wanna see something fun? I hope it's not a video or a music. If it is a picture, then it's alright, because I don't want to mess with my computer right now. Let me see, I think it was this one. No, it wasn't that one. But what happens if I return there now that the honeycomb thing was moved to somewhere else? Okay, I can't use it again. Yeah, let's say yes to him. Right, that's the spirit. Take this with you. And what's this? A second class citizen work permit? Or permit? I don't know how the accent is for that word. Just like mine. With that, you can move about more freely without arousing suspicion. Well, if she's with you, there shouldn't be any problems. Well, I'll be at the tower entrance. Forecast? Oh, is it going to snow? Permit? Oh, I see a lot of rains in there. Oh my god. Thunderstorms, actually. Man, I hope the forecast is not like 100% right. So you can have some better days in the middle of that. Gonna need some rubber. Joe dancing, hi, how are you doing? Hope you're having a great weekend. How are you? So it's permit. Permit. Okay, permit. In here we had some rainy days. I would say in the beginning of the week. But then when it got to Thursday, it was over. And then we had a sunny Friday, a sunny Saturday, and a sunny today, a sunny Sunday. But it was interesting that in the beginning of the week, if I'm correct, we had the coldest day so far in Rio of the year. I think it was like 14 degrees Celsius or something. But that's probably nothing to you all. That's probably super chill summertime and no cold at all. Or not cold at all. During all those thunderstorms, it's gonna be 80 degrees, pretty warm, with high humidity. 80 degrees Fahrenheit, I think it is something around 30 degrees Celsius or something. Going on a float trip? Oh, that's funny, because yesterday Meowser was also telling us about getting to a float trip. I wonder if you're going in the same float trip as Meowser. Just imagine. Oh wait, minus 28 Celsius? No way I'm trying that. Are you kidding me? Joe Dancing, how much days, how many, right? How many days are you spending in the place you are going? The human body is... Oh, so it's not close to 30 degrees Celsius. It might be 20 something then. Damn, Riker, are you serious? By the way, that's a word that... You're kidding me, right, Joe Dancing? Do you really know Meow, sir? No, you might be joking. Are you serious I said that? Because Meow, sir mentioned that he would be going to a... to the thing, to the float trip. Are you serious? No way. But Riker, that's a word that I should remember, although saying that sounds weird. Because every time I want to say the thing that our noses produce, I use the word mucus, but maybe it's not is a better word. What's a float trip? It's the... It's like rafting, right? You get those huge inflatable boat things or rafts, and then you go to a river place and then you have fun with it, and then you go down the river current. That seems to be a float trip. I learned that yesterday. Yeah, it's like rafting. Also, speaking about that, help me again about this word. But I think it is pronounced like... buoy or something? Isn't it buoy? Oh, it's buoy. Okay, buoy. Okay, buoy. Yeah, I was also trying to explain the raft thing by using that word, but I wasn't sure how to pronounce it again. So I kinda said other words instead. So it's buoy. Okay, buoy. It's not buoy, it's buoy. You're going Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and then back for Thursday and Friday. You are really going with Meowser, you're not joking, because Meowser said that there was one day that he needed to go back to work and then he would return to the place again. Oh my god! You are really a friend of Meowser. That's the same schedule. I hope you guys have fun. I hope you guys have a lot of fun in there. And he said that he would be bringing beer and food. I don't know if you guys will have like... I don't know how far from civilization you guys will be like. So I hope everything goes well in there. Say hi to Meowster for us, yes. I don't know how common it is for you guys to go to float trips or something. Maybe it is more common than I imagine. But when Joe Dancing was telling me this story, I was like, really? What a coincidence. But maybe it's normal, maybe it's common, maybe it is something that many people do like every weekend or so. And that reminds me that earlier today I was watching a YouTube video, and it was one of those funny videos, very, very fast or quick funny videos. And the joke was about a scene of Pirates of the Caribbean, and they were like, sighting, is that correct? They were like sighting a new boat, a new ship, and they were wondering what the hell was that ship or what's going on, and the other ship was coming closer to them, and then the joke happened, they shifted the scene to a person above or on five stacked rafts and then going down the riverbank by controlling five freaking rafts stacked together. So that was crazy. That was something that I never have seen someone trying to do before, like going down the river current by riding 5 stacked rafts, a big one and then a smaller one, like a pyramid. So that was a fun video. That's how 90% of horror movies start. Field trips, camping. That's actually true. That's actually true. Many horror movies, they have that theme or that idea, especially the slasher ones. Actually, there is a Netflix series called Slasher, and the second season of it was just like that. People going to a place in the mountains, and then things start getting bad in there. It's definitely a regional thing. Never heard of Flow Trip before. Yeah, I also haven't heard of it, but then after the explanation, I thought it was something common or so. But anyways, now we need to go to the tower, right? Wait, Samson was disguised? From here on, it will be better if we split up. It's a maze, so we... Oh no, it's a maze? F in advance. That's why I never go camping. I don't go camping just because I can't sleep very well with outside my own room, you know? So maybe if I could sleep easier than how it is to me, I would... Oh my god, I can't return. I'm really stuck in here. If I had better sleeps, or if I could sleep better anywhere I decide to go, I would try camping. Camping is boring. I think it depends. It depends on who is going with you, or it depends on the weather, it depends on the place, it depends if it is like a place that also has more people camping, like other groups camping, that can be annoying too, because then you wouldn't have privacy. I don't know, it depends, but it doesn't work for me because I won't be able to sleep very well. I will probably stay awake during the entire night, unless I find ways to get super super tired, and then I would sleep thanks to exhaustion. Right there. Oh, that's Samson. Unless there is Wi-Fi, then no camping. I would survive. I would be able to survive without Wi-Fi. Especially because just recently I got internet to my smartphone. So I can totally survive. Maybe I wouldn't survive if I didn't have something like music, but I would be able to survive without Wi-Fi. But I would like to have music. So I can't open those doors. So there is no way for me to explore here. Although there are two elevators, and we came from there. Okay, so I can explore at least the elevators. What happens if I take this one? Oh, there is a chest right there. Let's take care of this and move on. Do you mean like, are we fighting? I see the guard thing going after us, and he saw us. What are you doing? You are ordered to withdraw. Oh no. Is this like... Oh my god, this will be a freaking... this will be a freaking stealth part of the game. Oh yeah, the bugs can also be very annoying. Yeah, it's a freaking stealth part, seriously? The last time I was doing stealth action, I think it was in Beyond Good and Evil. By the way, Beyond Good and Evil is a great, it's a great game, you guys should play it, for sure. Vadin says it's short. Okay, so I will be patient. Although I don't know where to go. Or what to do here, because those red lights, they don't do anything. Oh. Really? He was looking at the other direction. But come on, those freaking robots, they don't have eyes, right? So they can look to all the directions. I would play it, but I'm beyond good and evil. Sometimes it gets for free, actually. At least the one I got, the Beyond Good and Evil game I got, it was because Ubisoft gave it away for free on Uplay. 2 years ago, I think. You see, he's not looking... Never mind, let's not discuss about that. So what's going on in here? Another elevator? A dead end? No, those are doors, right? No? Oh, there is this path. Wait. This is the entrance. What just happened? I'm so confused. Yeah, it was the exit. Oh, but I was able to get... Maybe it wasn't the exit, but it just looks... It just looks like the exit. But I got the chest. So... Never mind! It looks a lot like the exit, but we did it. Not bad, I think I will let myself go on ahead. Wait, you are not a Gazo. What are you going to do? It's not a problem, I used underground tech to rewrite my ID. why is everyone killing? Actually, not killing, dying, right? Everyone is dying in every hour today in this game. It's useless to do that. You won't be able to get through without either a first class citizen ID or a military ID. Are we trying to, like, enter in the digital world? Solaris is rough, yes. Not sure if it was a good idea to come here. But are we really trying to, like, enter the Matrix? Then what we are... Wait, then what are we going to do? Well, we can't just stand here. They are dying to get to the end of the game. They are. I guess it's not... Wait, now I can't focus anymore. I guess it's going to have to be all or nothing. If it doesn't work out, we'll worry about it later. Is what you are saying? Isn't that kinda sounding like Bart? Are they really wanting to enter the Matrix? How rude, it's not like I always go in without a plan. Okay, but at least she's... Oh, never mind, that's just... Okay, I get it now. They are not entering the Matrix. That's just like a... I don't know, a security thing. Because what Ellie really wants to enter is the door ahead of her. Or ahead of her. What's wrong? Well, I have done so much. I'm surprised they haven't labeled me as a traitor yet. Good point. Maybe they have objectives regarding you? You think it's because they haven't reported it? To the gambler, it would be like admitting failure and all. I hope so. Anyway, let's go. Okay. Oh, stay very close to me. That way it shouldn't pick up your presence. That's so risky. And they do it, like, without a single problem. I kinda want to try getting back, but I can't. Faye, where are you going? I wanted to try. Okay, so what's going on in here? I really feel like I'm missing stuff behind because I got to the right place very fast. Why they had to do this so confusing? You see, the room is just like the same room as before. Stay close to me, closer. I don't know which reference was that. But as long as we survive in here, that's good. Hey, why are you coming out of there? Come over here. I'm an Imperial? That's the second time I'm struggling with that word. Emperor. So maybe it is Imperial. I'm an Imperial Special Forces Lieutenant. And then her name that I don't know how to say. Ellen Van Houten. I have just completed the collection of the special levy of the third class level. I am now in the process of taking the surface dweller back to headquarters. Any problems with that? Gabler? No problems, please go on. So they are scared of us. Why? Maybe because everything here is dangerous or can kill you in a second. The one behind you is the gambler. I heard the lambs destroy the gate. Is everything okay? Should I be real? I will be real, it's questionable. Quit joking, that's impossible. It's not impossible. Why I can't talk to this person? Yes, oh, there is a mistake. Not again, this is why I hate government offices. You have got a lot of guts going into an area full of those barbarians. Only a gabbler could do that. This is not the music I would expect to a place like this. It sounds a lot like Grant Kirkhope's work. Just like Banjo-Tooie and Banjo-Kazooie. And also the visuals in here, they make me think on Wall-E. How was the ship called in Wall-E? I don't think I will be able to remember, but the ship, right, where the humans are located, it just looks like this. As a service to the citizens, we now are accepting data for the marriage service. Man, this music is so Grant Kirkhope's. The Central Control Bureau will pick the very best match for you. Our motto is good matches make good descendants. We are the seed that came from it, so of course we are the best. That's not how things happen. You look rather odd. Third class citizens should dress more appropriate. What do you think of these pogo shoes? They were made from the newest technology. They don't put stress on your spine, they are the best. The Imperial model is a super cool ultra rare item. There seems to be a big struggle on the surface, but it has absolutely nothing to do with us. As long as the Emperor is with us, we can live in peace. Jumping out of a frying pan just might land you in the fire. That stupid Ransus hasn't learned that yet. Paisley, hey, welcome! Thank you so much for the host, how are you? I just got to a crazy, modern, and Wall-E City. Just looking down and seeing the earth, I think, those poor souls can't live in this fine city. Even if they destroy the gate, it's all a waste of effort. A futile residence from those who will never reach our paradise. Well, we were able to come here, so maybe others can do the same. I'm not saying it was easy though. The Emperor will give the speech himself. He can't stand to see our confusion anymore, so he went out of the way to make an appearance. We should be thankful. Are you Itran's trolling? What? Itran's trolling is walking along the Itranink. Oh, so this is Itranink? Okay, so this is the Itranink. This is the Solaris capital. You need to download the Itran guide to do it. You are doing okay? I'm doing alright too. The day has been pretty chill and I'm finally doing some major progress in the game. Because for the past weeks, All I was doing in the game was to finally get to this place. So I'm glad to be there. The central control always has fun things. It's their job to keep the citizens happy. What? That's a hologram. The DK-1200 is so cool. They improved it so it dances and sings perfectly. I can't wait to download the newest songs. I still can't believe this place has this music. Up ahead is Argo Plaza. The dedication ceremony is about to start, but you don't have a ticket, so... These are special seats for the dedication. No ticket? You can't go in. Dedication ceremony? Solaris is probably not doing so well now. Huh? Why do we have to watch this? We decided to meet everyone. We don't have time to go this... Wait, we don't have time to go this festival? This is no ordinary festival. The people are disturbed by the gate's disappearance. The dedication is probably to quell the masses. We must check Solaris' stance against land dwellers. Faye, we need to get tickets. Where the hell can we find tickets? I guess we have to get some info on the enemy. Hurry up, there is not much time till the dedication. Can I find tickets inside here? Oh, that's an elevator. The Solaris Sound Service. The top new songs. DK-1200 NTG Love Car. Skyhook Elevator Song. Remy Solaris Sunset. Download these new songs at the nearest terminal. We recommend DK-900... 50. Users upgrade to the DK-1200. I don't have a single DK thing. Danger ahead. Oh, it's because it's the freaking... I don't know, road? No, this is different. The newest model, anti-grav car Roach, the design needs a little work. Yeah, this is different. You look rather odd. Oh, wait. No, I talked to these people before. So, this will take me back to where I was before? No, this is a new place. My son bugged me so much, I just had to get him a hybrid alloy. So this is like a shop. I will be so proud if he joins Gabler? If he joins Gabler when he grows up. What should I do? What do you think? What about this one? How about that one? I will say, how about that one? Really? I'm getting more and more lost. There are so many Imperial models out now. It's a limited edition, so I gotta buy it. I'm so indecision. I don't know what to buy, don't bother me. Let's see how things are in here, although I don't have money. Oh, this is the Ticketmaster? Ripstream? I saw that... my frame rate dropped to zero and then it's back. Is everything alright? This place is Midgar? Maybe a little bit. But let me know if the stream is alright, because yeah, it's